So is this market moving? Is the market telling you that, I mean, markets always climb the wall of worry. So is this a classic sign that markets are telling you that the economic dip is not going to be that bad as what we are anticipating? Or is this market really getting ready for some kind of, you know, blow up in coming days? Let's discuss that with Krishna Kumar Karma. KK, good morning. Thank you for joining us. Let me put two and two together, the news and the views. The news is no medical breakthrough. Economy is not going to come back to normalcy for next 3 to 4 quarters, and that's an optimistic scenario. FI flows have been here and there. The views which you've got from every corporate is the following, that they are not in a position to give any guidance because they don't know what is coming next. So if news and views are negative, why are markets holding so strongly?
Good morning once again, Nikunj. The dilemma that we have today in terms of what you rightly said, that there is strategy going forward, but still markets are, but let's look at it this way, that today what markets are discounting is the past of the corporates. So markets are basically past of the corporates and the historical perspective, that typically whenever for whatever reasons markets have corrected very sharply, they have made a comeback, and the comeback is typically led by the large corporates or the leaders which are there. So what we are seeing now also is that there was this fear, and rightly so, in terms of the pandemic, and the markets corrected very sharply from 12,500 odd to 8,000 odd, 7,500 odd, and then some kind of introspection in the market participant in terms of what's the underlying value of the various businesses. And you believe that many of these businesses do have the financial strength and the visionary capabilities to navigate the uncertain future. And so, and investors have a fixed allocation in terms of their equity, debt, etc. So whatever is the equity allocation, many investors are keeping true to that. And within that, then there is a portfolio churn which is happening. So this rally is more rally because of the post the sharp correction, and also reflective of the underlying fundamentals of many of the large corporates who are possibly going to be winners over a longer period of time. As you rightly said, that does any corporate have any visibility in terms of the next 12 to 24 months about their business? Possibly no. But the fact remains that investors tend to believe that these are the corporates who will innovate and who will be able to cross the hurdle whenever it comes. So I think that is what is reflective, and rightly so.
We had a couple of market old boys on the channel yesterday, and they said, look, this is a bear market rally, don't get excited. If you missed on, don't worry, markets will come down. The train has not left the station. The train will come back to where it started from. It will give you a great entry opportunity. What are you telling your clients? So asking a simple question, that have we missed the bus? Has the train left the station?
No, I think the smartest thing in a market always is that you should never feel left out. At every point of time, there will be opportunities for investors to invest in. So it doesn't make sense to chase stocks until and unless the valuations you feel are in your comfort zone. So what we are saying is that, okay, there has been a rally from 7,500, 8,000 to 9,500, etc. So that doesn't mean that we chase stocks accordingly. I think there will be corrections going forward as more and more data points come forward in terms of the impact on the economy, domestic economy, how the global economy is shaping up. So we will be in for a period of a lot of volatility in the next 12 months at least. But I think within that, the trick is all about, are you invested in the right sectors or the right stocks? That's where a successful investor will distinguish himself from an average investor. And I think we are already seeing signs of that in terms of the churn that the portfolios are taking place, or the sectors which seem to be outperforming. And these are early days. So my sense is that investors are churning their portfolios, going reducing their weight from some of the portfolio for some of the sectors which they believe may not deliver adequate returns. So is this a bear rally? I don't have an answer, but within that, yes, there can be a lot of volatility, and investors should be more looking at their individual stocks rather than trying to figure out where the market direction is headed.
I'm getting a divided view on how should one approach financials, KK. Now, financials hold the key. It's 35-40% of the weightage. You cannot have a scenario where financials don't play a role in economy. Similarly, you need to be realistic that financials will not grow at the rate at which they have grown for last 10 years because of NPAs, consumption slowdown, impact on fee-based income, consolidation. We both know the factors. But if somebody says, KK, should I remain 40% overweight in financials, or it's time to bring it down to 20-25%. How would you advise?
See, financials are at the end of the day a leverage play. They are all companies or banks, NBFCs, etc. are basically 5 to 7 times leveraged, and they are an indirect play on the various direct businesses. They lend to people, they lend to individuals, they lend to businesses in the hopes that the borrower will be able to repay on time. My sense is that in an uncertain environment where the direction of the economy is not very clear, at least for the medium term, where the risk is very high in terms of rising NPAs, I think it makes sense for investors to be more invested in direct businesses than trying to invest in the leverage business, which is what banks are all about. Yes, what you rightly said, that can an economy grow without the banking system growing? No, it cannot. But that doesn't mean that you as an investor also have to be invested in that sector. So my sense is that banks, what has happened of late is that only the top 2, 3, 4 banks, they are in a sweet spot as far as the liability profile is concerned. So they will continue to grow and they will be the drivers of the economy. But in terms of the multiple, I think probably the best of multiples are behind them. So you could see earnings growth, but there could be some valuations degrowth which could happen in the banking system. As we have rightly said earlier also about NBFCs, I think that business segment is also impacted. Banks don't want to lend to them. The bond market also doesn't seem to be keen to lend to them. So apart from a few NBFCs, the leaders in their segments who have the ability to raise resources, the sector as a whole, otherwise the second tier, tier 3 NBFCs will struggle. So to answer to your question about reducing your weight in your portfolio, yes, I think it makes sense to be relatively underweight as far as the banking financial services are concerned. I think it's better to invest in, say, maybe AMCs or insurance companies, etc., or wealth management firms, which probably will give better returns over a period of time than the banking system itself, than the lenders.
Sure. Outside of the purview of financials, KK, where else do you find opportunity in this market? And have you been a buyer yourself from the March lows to now?
Yeah, the market has already signaled where it wants to be. If you see the rally which has happened in the pharma stocks, the healthcare sector per se. So I think clearly there seems to be, there is an underweight in that sector and there are some tailwinds also. So investors are rotating money out of that sector, out of the financials, etc., into the pharma sector. I think the trick today is in an uncertain local and global environment is all about where do you see relative demand certainty. So again, telecom is one sector where the demand is not an issue. So you have seen telecom stocks also doing very well or reasonably well. Pharma, as I said, is doing well. Thirdly, I think utilities, I think they seem to be in a sweet spot as far as the demand environment is concerned, or at least their revenues are kind of stable. So they also have rallied from the lows. So these are some of the sectors where money is rotating into in an uncertain demand environment. Consumer staples are expected to do well, but maybe valuations is something which is of concern to many investors. So these are some of the sectors where you're possibly seeing money rotating into. consumer discretionary or large consumer discretionary, etc. I think only over a period of time will you come to know. Another sector which seems to be in a sweet spot is the specialty chemicals and the agrochemical sector. I think with the supply chain changes, etc., expected over a period of time, with China being disfavored, so we are seeing a lot of opportunities and in the domestic specialty chemical sector, and many of the companies over there, as far as working, etc., is concerned, they are doing well, and even market is recognizing that, and they have shown a very sharp bounce up.
Sure. What happens to pure play consumption, KK? And, you know, while there's no taking away from the fact that consumption in particular staples have also taken a fair amount of hit, but, you know, that can be classified as necessities. The only thing that you're buying right now is your FMCG products. So do you think there's, in that sense, COVID-proof, or do you think they too would bound to get hit because the supply chain network has gotten damaged regardless?
See, I think investors will tend to take the quarter one, quarter two underperformance of companies as a one-off. So once you stop something in terms of business and then you resume, it takes 2, 3, 4 months for things to become normal. So whatever interactions we have had with corporates who have resumed their businesses in the last 10, 15 days, I think it's a gradual process in terms of reaching their fair capacity utilization, etc. I think that will take at least, most of the corporates are saying that they assume that it will take at least 2 to 3 months for them to be back to normal, assuming that the lockdown, etc., is lifted gradually across the country. So investors would look at all corporate performance from a perspective that, okay, the first 3 to 6 months is a one-off. Investors would look at what can be once the economy is back on track in terms of FY22 expectations, and then they would be looking to invest in. As far as domestic consumption staples, yes, I think it will make a comeback. As far as consumer discretionary is concerned, which is largely financed, I mean, there's a huge amount of financing which is involved in that segment. I think that will be a function of how job losses, MSMEs, etc., are performing, and the willingness of the NBFCs, etc., to be willing to lend. Or so that's going to be, it's very finance supported to how finances are able to fund those consumer discretionary expenses, consumer durables, etc. That will be driven more by availability of finance and the risk appetite that investors or other the consumers would have to take on those extra EMIs.
Sure. KK, great to have you on the show and getting your perspective on where investors should look at. We also spoke with Dilesh Shah from Envision Capital.